Hi again, it's Jason from Fraser Valley Rose Farm, and today I want to talk about propagating plants in the winter. Whether you're propagating for a business like me or just propagating plants so you can have some extra for your garden next year or to give away to friends, this time of year is a shame to waste. You have months now before spring. The techniques I'm going to talk about today, I'm going to break this video up into three parts. The first one I'm going to talk about is hardwood cutting technique. It's been a while since I've done a video on that, and since then I've refined my technique somewhat, so I want to show you what I'm doing now for hardwood cuttings. Second thing I want to talk about is doing or continuing on with more active cuttings later into the season. I took cuttings 3-4 weeks ago, and now of course I've pressed past the point where they're really in favorable temperatures, but I want to show you how I've set up inside to keep those cuttings going later into the season. Third thing I want to talk about is how to maintain the cuttings that you took earlier in the season, how to manage those over the winter. I get that question an awful lot. I'm going to be indexing those into the bar of the video below or as chapters, so you can skip to the one you are the most interested to. So let's talk about hardwood cuttings. So hardwood cuttings. This is my new method. I'm going to call it the red cup method, which is basically just red cups from the grocery store, holes drilled in the bottom, and coarse sand that I got from the local gravel yard, and the cuttings stuck into it. Now, I switched over to this because the rate of success I was getting on sticking them directly into the garden, just in holes that I'd done with my pitchfork, was somewhere around 50%, maybe a little bit less than that in some cases. And what I found is that that garden bed, well, that soil may have pathogens or life in it. I'd heard people glow about the kinds of results that they get using coarse sand because it's a relatively inert material, and also it's pretty hard to overwater, although it does stay moist for a long period of time. So I'm excited to see what kind of results I can get using this method. Let's head out to the garden and grab ourselves some stems to cut with. Well, this one looks like a good candidate as a mother plant for my hardwood cuttings. Time of year indicates that everything on this rose should be firm. So looking at a stem like this one here, it's hard to bend. With my hand here, I'm trying to put a bend into it, but I can barely do so. That's the sign that you have firm hardwood. Now, one clarification about the hardwood cuttings technique is you're not trying to take it from old growth, like stuff at the base of the plant that's thick and crusty and 2 years old. You want fresh stems from this year of growth. So that's what I'll be taking off of this here. You start with a clean, sharp blade as always, and for this step out in the field, I'm just going to go ahead and take long stems. I'll cut them into shorter sections when I get into the greenhouse. So something like this, I'm probably going to get 3 or 4 good cuttings off of it, and I'll bring in a few stems like this so we can have lots of practice. And there we go. You can see it's definitely fall now because all the hips on this are ripening up. We've got some red berries on this going into the fall. I'll take these in and I'll chop them up for hardwood cuttings. I've demonstrated how to take cuttings plenty of times before, but one thing that's different about hardwood cuttings is that I'm going to go ahead and strip off all of the leaves. This is because I'm expecting this propagation step to take somewhere in the range of 4 to 6 months to fully root, and then it will send out new leaves from these nodes along the stem here. The second major difference is that the size of these cuttings is a little bit longer. I'm going to take a cut just above a node on this end, and I'm going to go all the way down to this node here and take a cut just below a node on the other end. And so you can see that this entire cutting is somewhere in the range of 6 or 7 inches in length. My average cutting that I take for propagation within the growing season, that's semi-hardwood cuttings, is usually at least one node shorter than this, and might average in the range of 5 inches and be softer. And I want to again just show you that the end of this stem here is still a little bit bendy, and that's sort of that semi-hardwood stage. That's what I want to avoid for hardwood cuttings like this. That would be more appropriate earlier in the season. The sticking method itself couldn't be easier. You fill up the red cup with the holes in the bottom with coarse sand. Then take your cuttings one by one, stick them in the rooting hormone. This rooting hormone has 0.8% IBA. It could range up to 1% even is fine. Lower percentages could work, but I like the higher percentages for hardwood cuttings. Take the bottom of the cutting, dip it into the rooting hormone, then stick it into the cup, making sure to space them out as you put them in. Reason I didn't fill the cup entirely with sand right away just had to do with making this step easier. If you're trying to push through 3 or 4 inches of sand, it makes it a little bit harder to space these out and to get them to anywhere near the bottom of the cup. Once you've placed them in, then you can take another cup that has some coarse sand in it and then just fill up the rest of the way. And that's it, a little tap to compress it down. And now you have some nicely spaced cuttings. And of course, don't forget to label it with the name of the plant. Otherwise, you will definitely forget what they are by spring. The only other thing I'll mention in terms of care over the winter is just to occasionally come in and give these a splash of water. Temperatures. If in my climate, none of this hardened off tissue is at any risk from dying due to winter temperatures. As cold as it ever gets around here, it's no problem. So I do this outdoors in my greenhouse. My greenhouse has a little bit of shade on the covering just so it doesn't warm up too much in here and end up drying out the cuttings. If you were in a colder temperature climate, something that does get temperatures that would threaten this, and here I'm talking well below freezing, in that case, you might do this method indoors in a cool area, not a warm area, in an unheated area or a cool area that stays above zero, or stays above freezing, that is, and you can do that in a well air circulated area. That's the other thing you'd want to look at, is to make sure you have good air circulation. You don't want these to rot. Question number two, how late can you start pushing back active season cuttings or propagation towards the winter, or how far can you cheat? And I cheat plenty. Usually, if I were sensible, I would cut off most of my propagation in, say, late August or September and give the new cuttings a chance to root and then harden off before the winter. However, I keep on cutting all the way through September, sometimes into October, sometimes early November, as long as I can find material out in the garden that's in the right stage for active season cutting and not hardwood, which is what I just showed you. So when I'm talking about semi-hardwood cuttings or softwood cuttings, obviously that is the limiting factor, is that if you have plants out in the landscape that you're trying to do, they start to harden off and slow down, and then they become less likely to root for you. Let me show you inside how I've done with my cheating. You'll recognize my indoor growing area here, and this plant here is Fellowship, or oh, they also call it Live in the Easy. And this would be case in point of late season semi-hardwood cuttings that I took and I put them under lights and I kept the temperature in a favorable range and ended up with a rooting late in the season. Now, here's the trouble that I face now is that these have rooted. I'm gonna pull one out here if I can. Oh, there we go. So these have rooted, but they're rooted rather late in the season. Now here's the question. What do I do with these now? I can't put them directly into the greenhouse. The greenhouse has been cooling off outdoors pretty dramatically over the past few weeks, and these have been held in a warmer temperature. So I can start to phase down the temperature in this room to try to keep them over the winter, but it does make it a little bit awkward when I root them this late in the season. The other thing to say is that even though Fellowship was throwing some semi-hardwood stems late in the season, these took longer than normal to root. Normally I would have these taking probably 3 to 4 weeks for initial rooting. These took closer to 6 or 7 weeks for initial rooting. I think I took these sort of towards the end of September, so it took me a lot longer to get these rooted and to start getting some new growth on them. So that's what I get for trying to cheat the system. Let me show you one here where the condition of the plants limited my success. And these are boxwood cuttings, and if
classically you're trying to propagate boxwood, you would do the cuttings way back in June or sort of early summer would be a good time to get cuttings off of them. I took these ones again in that sort of late September range, and they have just sat here doing just about nothing. And let me pull one up here, and you can see has some callus across the bottom of the cutting there, but really no roots. I'm gonna just keep on poking around here and see if I can find anything with some roots on them. If there are, I'm not running across them very easily. Here's another one that has a bit of good callusing across the base. So they're not failing, but they're kind of sitting here, not succeeding either. I suspect they will continue to sit here and will eventually root, but it changes the timeline on it from a plant that would be relatively easy to root, again, in that 3 to 4 week range under favorable conditions and with the plant material or the donor material being receptive to rooting, and it takes it to a cutting that was taken later from harder material and moves it into, at this point, again, 7-8 weeks with just callusing barely, and it'll probably take them in the range of 3 to 4 months to come up with really decent roots. So this is the challenge with going late season or pushing the season as far as cuttings. It can be done, but you have to have a lot more patience, sort of low and slow for temperatures on this. And by the time I come out the other end, probably I'll have concluded that it would just be easier to wait and take the cuttings in June. Third topic for today is how to overwinter cuttings that have already rooted. This is really the part of the video that I'm talking directly to those people who've already succeeded with cuttings previously in the year. They have a whole bunch of cuttings like these ones that are lightly rooted or rooted ready to come out next spring. What do you do with them over the winter? And it very, very much depends on your climate. If you have a very mild climate, I'm talking New Zealand or California, you don't have anything to worry about. You can leave them outdoors, no protection, no problem. In my climate here, we get close to the freezing mark pretty frequently during the winter, and sometimes we get an outflow or kind of an extreme weather event where it goes well below freezing for a short length of time. So it's a tough call for a guy like me. Do I leave them outside and leave those tender roots subject to the kinds of weather that I'm going to get over this winter, or do I protect them indoors? Other people have asked me the same question. Should I take them all in and grow them under lights, grow them at high temperatures? I would prefer a lower temperature rather than a higher temperature. Plants like these that have been through a season of growing and they're rooted, they can take something approaching freezing. So for roses like these, say 2 or 3 degrees Celsius or 35 degrees Fahrenheit is not going to be a problem for them to handle. If they get those temperatures out in a greenhouse like this, out in the garden, not a big deal. Even indoors, that's fine. Going through the winter over with high temperatures is going to force you to take care of them while they're growing actively, which is a little bit harder to do. You have to provide high light levels, you have to manage for pests, you have to feed them, and air circulation, all the other things that they don't get in an outdoor environment. You have to provide all of those in an indoor environment. It makes it a little bit trickier. So I like to do it at a lower temperature, but I don't want to tip below freezing by any amount for any length of time for rose cuttings. So what I do on these is, on this bench here, I built in a safety. I did a video on that a couple weeks ago where I tried to build an underbench heating to try to keep it from staying those low temperatures over winter. Now, if you don't have a backup heater to try to keep them in above freezing temperatures, then I'd suggest you get them inside. And I would suggest the best environment for it is an area where you have lower temperatures, something like a garage, something like a shed, that isn't heated or isn't heated well and really, but does stay above freezing temperatures. That's a tough call of where that spot is in your environment. So you have to think about that. The other thing to say is that these are semi-active. They don't need a ton of light, but a little bit of indirect light would definitely help. Even a little bit of supplemental lighting for a few hours a day, 4 to 6 hours a day, to get them some LED lighting would be a good thing. just watch for the signs that they're, again, at low temperatures, they're not going to grow quickly, but if they're trying to stretch for light, or if they're growing and you don't, and they're pale, getting pale and elongated, that's something that would indicate to you that they're not getting enough light, and you're going to have to supplement in that case. Definitely am open to questions on this topic, because it's the topic that I get asked about this time of year quite a lot. So if you have questions about this or anything else I've talked about in the video, please drop those into the comments below. Thanks so much for watching.